going to be showing you how to make the uplifting white noise effect, otherwise not too many people has the whoosh effect. You'd hear it on pretty much every dance track in the market today, and it's quite a simple effect to make. You can do it using the FL Studio native plugins, and today we're going to be using the 3X OSC. The first thing you're going to want to do is insert it. So if I just right click there, go to insert and 3X OSC. So if we have a listen to this, should sound pretty nasty. You've just got your plain old white noise, same kind of thing that comes out of your TV. So what I've done here is changed all three of the waveforms to noise, which is these little squiggly lines here. 2, 3. So next thing you're going to want to do is send this to a mixer track. If you just go up here to the top right corner, it says FX, slide it up, and I've moved it on to number 1. So I'll just rename that noise, just so I know what it is. So, in order to get the noise to actually play throughout your track, you need to put it into a pattern. So, with the 3X OSC selected, go up to this little button here, it's the piano roll button. If you click that, it'll open up the piano roll. So what you want to do is put about 4 bars worth of notation in. I'll just drag that along. So it should just play through. Yep, not very nice. So to make this sound actually turned into the uplifting whoosh effect, you're going to need to filter it. To do this, we're going to use the Fruity filter. So if you go back on your noise mixer track, in the first input, you want to drop down and find the Fruity filter. So I've got this here. For your all the adjustments you need to set, you want to have your resonance turned up full, the low pass turned up full, the band pass turn right down, high pass turn right down, and your times 2, make sure that's off. So now if I will play through, and I'll play about with a cutoff just so you can hear the effect. So that's basically it. That is how you make the sound. So what you want to do now is actually control that sound in a track. So if I bring in the playlist here, just make that a little bit smaller. To get this up, you click this button here, which is the playlist button. And as we've made pattern 1, which we made before, I'm going to just drop that in here. So if I close that playlist and we go back to the Fruity filter, if I right click cut off frequency, click create automation clip. Now what this is going to do is send a controllable clip to the playlist, which is this here. So now you can create the shape of what you want your noise to sound like. A lot of producers will just put a straight line going up, which I think is pretty boring. But what I find works very well, gets a lot of attention, is a kind of S shape. Obviously this is just totally down to personal choice. I'll just adjust this a bit, yeah. So if I have a listen to both of them. And that is basically it. To get some better transitions with this, you can add delays, reverbs, pretty much anything you want. It's totally down to artistic interpretation. But we're going to be doing more tutorials on transitions between tracks, as that's what this actually is. So just keep an eye, watch this space, rate, comment, subscribe, and if there's any tutorials that you'd really like to see, don't hesitate to drop us an email on info@goldshorerecords.com, and don't forget to check out the website, which is www.goldshorerecords.com. Thanks.